get into 17 years commitment working on the working at the grassroots level. So I was given three tasks. I was given task to build seva in Delhi and outside Delhi, and so that was my first hand experience working with women. So now when I went to Harvard, I decided that when I come back, I will start something to rejuvenate the government education system in India. To start, and I will start this from Bihar.
Absolutely, because I think education is something which, at the grassroots level is where it all starts.
Right, right. And we all are product of education.
Absolutely.
Without education, we are nowhere.
Yeah.
As I mentioned in the beginning, the education system in states like Bihar, UP and Rajasthan, the government education system has gone down. It has deteriorated. And even now, about 65 to 70% students are going to government schools and colleges. But if you look at the figures from Bihar, so the dropout rate is huge.
Yeah.
Between 1 to 10th grade, the dropout rate is 70%. And between 18 to 23 years of age, there are about 1 crore 25 lakh young people, young folks. And out of that, like only 1.75 lakh, they are enrolled into colleges. So my argument, is, and I have written a piece in Times of India. My argument is that a state like Bihar is a fit case for demographic disaster. And it's a man-made disaster which we are seeing. And it's only because now the kids of influential people in middle class, they are no longer going to these schools.
Right.
So we are not the stakeholders. So we don't want to, we are not bothered. We are, I also found, I described myself that there's a difference between sympathy and empathy. Like when the air is bad in NCR, everyone is worried, rich, from rich to poor. Poor people are less bothered. And rich is, they are more bothered about the air, because here we all are taking air. But for the schools and the public health system, the rich are not bothered at all. Now we are sending our kids to good school so that they can send their kids to a better school and get good, health, access to good health system. So, with this, all this in mind, we started a campaign. It's a voluntary, it's all volunteer and campaign. I mobilized a lot of students from Delhi University, and we started going to Bihar. And we have started Jan Shiksha Yatra, and within in next 1 year, we are planning to reach out to all the districts, organizing people to come forward and start Gyan Daan. So we all have so much to give. So it's a kind of campaign which we are running. We have formed a campaign called Ed Justice People Campaign. Ed Justice is education justice. And that is how we are doing. And it's a passion. It's not my job. My job is different. My passion is different. So that is what I am doing currently.
Brilliant.
Apart from my job.
So I guess in order to help at an individual and society level to break this many forms of glass ceiling, it's important to not just work at the ceiling level, but start at the grassroots level.
Exactly.
And that is when education and growth of a young mind actually takes shape. Because ultimately these are all man-made biases,
right,
which we uphold unconsciously, subconsciously in a society as we grow up. So if you want to change any man-made biases, it is we as men and women who have to start at a very young age to overcome these challenges that it takes later on in our lives. So great. I think what we are really saying there is that breaking the glass ceiling is also about literally fixing the glass ladder. Because it's not just about reaching a point in your career where you cannot go into leadership levels, but it is also about fixing each step of the ladder along the way. Because in our society, there are so many challenges which we face while reaching that glass ceiling itself. So it's about fixing the glass ladder and then finally shattering the glass ceiling.
And as you would likely say, probably start at grassroots level. Yes, Sanjay, you can sum up.
Yeah, very quickly. Since I think you're Swati. Yeah, she's running. Okay, she's running out of time. Okay. So,
I'm Niharika.
Niharika, sorry. So, you know, it's now that we are working with the little children in the preschool, we realize that it's very important for parents to inculcate and the educators to inculcate a respect or towards to society, like towards women or towards the underprivileged people, that to inculcate that kind of a feeling. And you know, I would like to tell the children or the youngsters that you have to dream. Come what may, you have to dream and you have to work towards achieving those dreams. And I would request the parents that please let your child, let your children dream. Let them let them do what they want to do. That's how we can really achieve this breaking of the glass ceiling for the society as a whole. Thank you.
Thank you.
And I request you to stay back for a moment because we would love you to felicitate our gifting partner, the Date House. May I please invite on stage Ms. Vandana Ram to receive the felicitation. Ladies and gentlemen, please give it up for our gifting partner, the Date House. We have here with us Ms. Vandana Ram from the Date House. And NILF 2019 is very, very grateful to the Date House for their invaluable love and support to us throughout.
Congratulations.
Congratulations. Niharika, can you announce the books are available at back?
So the books are available right at the end of this hall, at the stall. Please do have a look, do browse through them. I'm sure you will find your favorites and you will have a ton of reading to do at the end of this hall.
Thank you.
It was amazing.
Great, good that
you could make it.
Well, while we are at the Literature Festival, it is absolutely not possible that we be in conversation with our readers.
Thank you so much. Pleasure.
Have them read out from their books.
Thank you, sir.
So on that note, let me invite on stage Mr. Abhishek
Engineering colleague,
to read from his book, which is called The Curse of Shiva and Other Things. To give you a little introduction of him, he's a writer and he has a collection of
now I am retired from
the financial
capital
philosophy
and
spirituality
and technical
science.
Advisor on the
and his
of
debut
State
book
Bank
was
now
called The Lonely Drummer and Other Poets. Well, he was awarded the
and
top 100 inspiring authors of India in 2018 and the Swami.